The Republicans have a fascinating preemptive strike strategy. Now, they did it before President Obama debated Mitt Romney. A couple of days before the debate, they released a 2007 tape. They said, oh my God, it's breaking news, we have a tape nobody's seen before. In fact, everybody had seen the tape before. It was President Obama talking about Hurricane Katrina in 2007. In fact, the guy who broke the story was Tucker Carlson, who had previously run that same tape on MSNBC when he was a host on there in 2007. So he knows he's lying. He's lying through his teeth. So why do they do it? First, let's show you the tape, and then we'll tell you what the strategy was.
What's happening down in New Orleans? Where's your dollar? Where's your Stafford Act money? Tells me that somehow the people down in New Orleans, they don't care about as much.
Oh my God, what an angry black man. He was outraged by Katrina, whereas the rest of us weren't. Now that's an absurd charge, ridiculous charge. Now you can say, hey, you know what, his accent was a little funny there, right? And that might be a fair criticism, but angry black man. They didn't seem to care about you and Katrina. Of course, that was the whole problem with Katrina, right? So why did they do it when they knew it was an old tape? And that's not an angry black man at all, let alone the fact that that's an absurd way to frame anything to begin with. They did it a couple of days before the election because it was a preemptive strike. They said, President Obama, you better not attack Mitt Romney. You better not do it because then you would be an angry black man. And what did President Obama do? As he always does, he fell right into the trap. Now, he hasn't been doing it in this campaign, but for the last 4 years, as he's been governing, Fox News says, you better not do this. And Obama goes, okay, I'm not going to do it. You better fire Van Jones. Okay, I will do it. You better fire Shirley Sherrod. Okay, I'll fire Shirley Sherrod. So he fell for it again. All right, no, I'll take it easy on Mitt Romney. And then he wound up getting his ass kicked. So now with the next set of debates coming up, Paul Ryan versus Joe Biden, they're doing it again, but in a different way. In fact, in two different ways. First, they're attacking the moderator, Martha Raddatz. Now, how are they attacking Martha Raddatz? Well, they say, oh my God, we've got a connection. And it's the same guy. It's the Daily Caller run by Tucker Carlson. He's just become, I guess he was always part of the propaganda machine, but I think he just flat out gets paid to run these untrue smears, et cetera, all the time on a regular basis. In fact, Andrew Sullivan called him out on this. He said, they're about to do a smear campaign on Martha Raddatz and connect her to Obama, et cetera. And Tucker Carlson said, Andrew Sullivan's a nut job. By the way, he's totally right. Here it is. Right? Now, he didn't say he was right, but that's right, he was right. They ran this smear campaign. So what is it? Well, here's the Daily Caller. President Barack Obama was a guest at the 1991 wedding of ABC senior foreign correspondent and vice presidential debate moderator Martha Raddatz. Ah-ha! We got him! 1991. So why was he at the wedding? The groom, Julius Genachowski, and Barack Obama were Harvard Law School classmates and members of the Harvard Law Review at the time. Aha! They went to school together. Not Martha Raddatz necessarily, but Julius Genachowski, who she was getting married to. But as ABC News points out, wait a minute, President Obama went to school, Harvard Law School, with a lot of people, and a lot of them turned out to be Republicans, and he went to their weddings too. By the way, is Martha Raddatz still married to Genachowski? Nope. They got married back in 1991, of course. In 97, Raddatz and Genachowski divorced. That would be 15 years ago. They were now both remarried. And Genachowski in 2009 was appointed as chairman of the FCC by Barack Obama. So why are they doing this? Well, they say Obama connects to Genachowski, that connects to Raddatz. So Raddatz, you better make sure you lean to our side. If you ask any tough questions of Paul Ryan, well, that means you are biased because Obama was at your wedding and back in 1991 and connected through your ex-husband. We got you. So whatever you do, take it easy on Paul Ryan and be tough on Joe Biden so that you can prove you're not biased. And when does this get released? Right before the debate. But that's not all. Paul Ryan also did a radio interview where he had a second preemptive strike. And that was about, I can't believe they would ever call us liars. Here, watch this.
The president would love nothing else to distract us through the distortions. They're just going to call us liars for a month. It's basically what they're going to do, it looks like. People see through that stuff. And it seems pretty clear that their new strategy is just basically just call us liars, to descend down into a mud pit. And hopefully with enough mudslinging back and forth and distortion, people will get demoralized, and then they can win by default. sort of a choice of the lesser of two evils. I think that's the only strategy they seem to have left.
Do you understand the genius of that preemptive strike? He knows he's about to lie. That's what he did during his convention speech, and he got in a lot of trouble for it. A lot of the press called him out on it because their entire campaign is based on a lie. Their tax cuts for the rich are gigantic, and you can't pay for them, and they would destroy our budget. They would create giant deficits. He doesn't have a choice. He has to lie about that. He can't tell the truth. He can't say, oh, yeah, by the way, we'd add trillions to the deficit, even though we claim that we're the balanced budget team. He's got to lie. They say that they're going to cover people with pre-existing conditions, but their plan doesn't cover them. So he's got to lie. So what does he do? He says, oh, my God, these guys are going to call us liars. Can you believe that? They're going to get into a mud pit. So if they call us liars, it's not because we're lying. It's because they want to get into a mud pit. So he's trying to send a message to the press and to some degree to Joe Biden. You better not call me a liar, otherwise I'll turn around and go, see, I told you before the debate he was going to do that. That's their old tricks. Now, it's not just the Republicans. Of course, at every turn, they are aided and abetted by Fox News Channel. Fox News was the one that put out the tape on Sean Hannity's program about angry black man, Barack Obama. He literally said that. And now, here's Fox News supporting that same talking point by Paul Ryan.
Without vitriol, without name-calling. Monica, what happened to that strategy?
Well, you know, the Obama economy is in free fall, and you've got an Obama foreign policy in total collapse. And so they are out of political and rhetorical ammo, and they're also out of ideas. And so now they've been reduced to calling the other side liars.
And if you notice the banner, it also says some Democrats, really, which Democrats? Your Fox News channel, why don't you get them on the record or quote them off the record? Some Democrats say that Paul Ryan might lie during the debate. Can you believe that they would say that? We haven't even had the debate yet. So, media, you better be careful. Don't let the Democrats use their strategy of calling Paul Ryan a liar. Now, if you weren't going to lie during the debate, why go through all that trouble?